food shock or something like that.
Thanks for the words of comfort. See you later.
Sure.
You know, I'd hold the door open for you there, but I want you to enjoy your last moment.
Very funny. Couple hours.
Bottom line is, if you hadn't showed up, your manager would have kicked out Black Bus right out of that door.
Well, if that's the way it happened, Hank, I'm...
the ladies.
So the manager had an attitude. I mean, that's probably part of his job description. I mean, for all you know, he looked at us and didn't see our color at all. Just three people he didn't know. Or maybe he had a headache. I mean, who knows why he decided he could skip us.
So you mean that the whole world is colorblind? You know, it seems to me that you were singing a different song last year when you lost that part in the show because you weren't white.
Come on, there is no reason to back Sheila into a corner. Of course racism is real.
You better believe it's real. Your mother and I went eye to eye, toe to toe, every day of our marriage. And it wore us down.
Well, it didn't have to. You needed to learn to live with it.
Oh, you mean rise above it and not let it affect us?
Kevin and I do.
So love conquers all, huh? Rachel, baby, it doesn't conquer prejudice.
Well, maybe you don't want it to.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means that we're all so very hungry and we're getting cranky. That's what it means. So, Kevin, how's school here?
Oh, it's good, I guess. I haven't been too sure lately about which way I want to go, though. Previously, I was looking more at business, but lately I've been thinking about taking a view to law.
Hmm. Then you would want to go to law school?
I guess, yeah. That's something I don't really know too much about. Would you be able to recommend a school, Hank?
Well, Kevin, with all that Buchanan money you've got to throw around, you can pick any school you like. Don't you people always go first class?
Us people.
He means smart people.
I should answer this. Excuse me, Sheila. Rachel. I'll be back.
Saved by the beeper. I am so sorry, Kevin.
Oh, for what?
For this dinner turning into an absolute disaster.
Is it? I hadn't noticed.
Please.
No, hey, really, I'm in a good mood here, all right? Big brother Cord is alive and well.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I could hardly believe it when I heard that.
Yeah. And on top of that, I'm having dinner with two very beautiful women. The only thing I could possibly ask for is when your father comes back, for him to just, you know, throw his arms around me and tell me how much he loves me. And I'll bet that's exactly what he's going to do.
Let me give you a word of advice, if I may. Hold on to your dream, okay? I mean, Hank may be a very stubborn son of a gun, but even son of a guns can come around. You know, if you want his support, Kevin, you'll find a way to get it. Trust me on this one. Well, look who's here. Whatever made me think this was going to be a boring dinner.
The one that waded into the river and pulled Sarah and me out of the car after the accident?
You found him?
Yeah, yeah. Well, it was mostly Nora's doing. She tracked him down.
Have you talked to the guy?
Not yet, but we've set up a meeting.
Well, listen, Bo. Don't go in expecting a lot. I mean, by the time that truck driver rescued you, the car that drove you off the bridge was almost certainly long gone.
Mind telling me what you're up to, Hank? Dropping the charges against Jason Webb?
Have you ever heard of a legal concept called presumption of innocence, Kevin? Maybe you ought to brush up on it if you're thinking about practicing law. I mean, before you throw the book at people, you need to review the facts, which I did. And the fact is, it looks more and more like your frat house buddies were setting up Jason.
No, wait, for what reason?
I don't know. You tell me. I mean, he's tight with them. In fact, I understand that one of them is his cousin.
So what does that prove? Are you saying that has something to do with Jason being arrested?
No. Look, all I'm saying that a man is judged by the company he keeps. And you hang with those wealthy playboy types. I suppose they get a little bored.
Wait a minute, Hank. Are you saying just because you're rich, you're guilty? I mean, that's like saying, oh, gee, look at that black man walking down the street with a VCR. He must have stolen it.
Now, you telling me that's not your first thought?
Excuse me. I hate to interrupt, but Hank, they are playing our song, dear.
This isn't our song.
It is now. Let's go. Excuse me. Come on, dear. Let's go. Come on, come on, come on.
So much for that question, huh?
What question?
Well, Hank's finally coming around about you and Rachel. No, you listen to me. Listen to me. You don't let this stop you, okay? Because life is too short and love is too rare. So you just hold on to what you got. And you hold on to each other. Now, you hear me?
Loud and clear, Uncle Bo.
You know what? I like this music myself. Would you mind taking me for a turn?
Excuse me.
I know your father dislikes me for dropping the charges against Jason.
Maybe Jason is innocent. Then why don't we just let Jason live his life? It's like your uncle said, life is short. Can we sit here?
You can stare at them until you get a crick in your neck. That won't change a thing.
So you might as well get used to Kevin and Rachel seeing each other, no matter how you feel about it.
You remember being that young?
Excuse me, pal, but for me it wasn't that long ago.
Yeah, well, I know. I'm what I'm saying is, just take a look at them. Look at the way they look at each other over there. Huh? Maybe love isn't dead after all.
Really, she didn't say anything to me about going away.
Yes, it took us here at the palace a bit by surprise. Excuse me.
Mom?
Hi, Mrs. Buchanan.
Kevin, Rachel.
What's with the bag? You going someplace?
Well, you're going to find out soon, and I might as well tell you. I'm taking a room here. The hotel for a few days.
Why? What's happened?
I can't explain it, Kevin. Just understand, please.
Understand what, Mom?
I love you very, very much.
Taking a room here in the hotel. She wouldn't tell me what was wrong. Could you talk to her, Uncle Bo? Please.
Oh. Hey, Vicky.
Bo, hi.
Hi. Are you meeting somebody for dinner? Can I join you?
I was actually going to have dinner alone.
Oh. Okay.
I don't mean to be rude. I just have a lot on my mind.
Well, would you like to talk about something with somebody? Vicky, I heard you're moving in here.
Well, bad news really travels quickly in this tiny little town of ours, doesn't it? Yes, I've taken a hotel room here. No, I don't know for quite how long. Yes, Clint and I are having problems. Yes, they are very major proportions. No, this is none of anybody else's business. Yes, I need to be alone, Bo. I hope that answers your question.
Huh?
boat. We took 9 o'clock. It's only 9:03.
Well, the guy drives a truck for a living. You think he'd know how important it is to be somewhere on time.